Hey guys, this is me, Psycho Break, and I want to share this with y'all. I want to share this case with y'all in this game. This game I played the Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep 0.2 fragmentary passage, and it took me about 3 hours and 13 minutes. Probably would have taken longer to get everything. In the game, it actually tells you that the sharing is not allowed. And and pretty much it, you know, tells you that's not allowed. So anytime you get to the part with Mickey Mouse, with that one, it actually cut off abruptly, and it blocks it to where nobody can see it. Now the 0.2 fragmentary edition passage, you're probably wondering, okay, it's a prologue, but prologue to what? Well, it's a prologue to Kingdom Hearts. This is what Aqua was doing while Sora was doing Kingdom Hearts 1. This is what she's doing. Matter of fact, she's the reason Mickey was able to get saved. She was the one that saved him, actually, by taking the darkness away from him. And pretty much she kept them from seeing what was really going on behind the scenes. And so that was, you finally get to see what Mickey Mouse's secret mission was that he had to do, which was pretty cool. But it only lasts 3 hours or 4 hours, depending on what you get. When you open up the game here, it comes with the advertisement for Kingdom Hearts, which actually ends up showing, end up releasing it on the day of mine and my girlfriend's anniversary, which is awesome. The other game you get is the Kingdom Hearts X back cover, which is basically based off of a mobile game, but apparently this is supposed to be how the Keyblades came to be. And then you get the first ever Dream Drop Distance. Now this game, don't expect to be knocked off your feet with this, because this was remastered compared to the 3DS version. So it kind of looks meh, but it's still a fun game. But I wanted to tell you this. If you bought the game strictly to play the fragmentary passage, then I would say don't buy it. I did a stream of it, and honestly, my reactions to it as I was playing, I was pissed off. This definitely feels like this was something that they felt like they had to tie up loose ends, but but it is that. But the Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance in the movie I haven't done yet. I may do a stream on that, but chances are that's going to be blocked too. But anyways, that's what I wanted to go over. So, it is a good game. However, don't get it strictly because of that. Get it because you either want to play this, but even then, it's overpriced. I went to Walmart, and if you have the Walmart app, right now they have this game going for $44.57. In the store, it's $59.99. But if you have your app on the phone, they will honor that. And so that's how I got this game at $44.57. So I saved about $13 bucks off of this, which is more than what should have been paid for it to begin with. So what is my game plans? What do I plan on doing? Well, it's actually simple. I tried to do some streaming a little bit on Beam on Twitch. I just checked my subs. It didn't make a difference. The numbers didn't drop, but the numbers didn't change. No one actually came and watched the Beam thing. I was doing wrestling. Then I started Final Fantasy. Then I was like, bump it. I'm done with that. I just woke up. I haven't had my morning coffee. With that said, give me just a moment. I'll be right back with my morning coffee. Want to give a shout out to my girlfriend for getting me this lovely cup. Also want to give a shout out to Dallas Beatty, who did this sticker. She's got a vinyl printing thing she does for $5. I got this. This is dual layered, actually triple layered. The eyes are different. These are different. It's all done perfected. So kudos to you, lady. Starbucks coffee caramel version. I get the big bags, and I do the, and I scoop little bits of them to use on my $30 Keurig thing. It's Fiberware, but who cares? All right, so what do I want to talk about? Well, first and foremost, let's get the bat, let's get the elephant out of the room. Right now, PlayStation has released a 4.5 update, which allows you to use your storage. And this storage, external hard drive, I took the one that I had from Xbox One and I used it for the PlayStation. Had 16 games to transfer and it took about 51 minutes. I just set it to do it overnight and I went to bed. And that's my cat. So that's that. And Share Factory Studios, I still need to work on that, obviously. But that is that. Upload Studios has crashed. It will not let you do anything. I don't know what they're doing. I don't know if they're fixing it, but Upload Studios, as of right now, you can't load a video. It says files are corrupted. That's their answer to everything because they want everybody to use Beam. And this is my Xbox. So I got my Xbox back, and I thank you to Dustin Pipkins for looking after my stuff. I had it at his house so his son could enjoy it and stuff and play it. But the other thing is that on the games themselves, on the Twitch channel, you know, I tried to do certain things. I couldn't see nobody, but everybody's dipping in, dipping out, whatever. So I can honestly say I don't like that. I don't like the fact I'll have to have my computer, I'll have to have my computer up, signed into my account to be watching on Twitch, and I'm just not down with that. I may do that, but after I got done update or uploading or doing the video, it didn't save or nothing. So it was like I did nothing, no videos to watch, no nothing. So I don't know how that works. But yeah, Upload Studios right now is crap. It's not even working. The other games I was wanting to do, I tried to do Borderlands 2. I was going to stream with Ninja Smurf do on Beam, but however, Borderlands 2 does not allow you to stream for whatever reason, so that wouldn't let me broadcast that. That's fine. That kind of sucked. We just talked for a little bit. I do want to say thank you for those that watch the stream. Thank you for those that show up. Even if it's just the one person or two or three, I appreciate it. But I understand that game was... I understand to watch that game was... I guess y'all haven't played Kingdom Hearts, so y'all didn't really understand where that's coming from. So I understand that. I understand that. That was kind of crappy in itself. Right now, as we speak, as far as the streaming on the PlayStation, obviously that's a lot easier, but it's aggravating that Xbox One claims to be all this stuff and it's not doing. I mean, they're everything. I mean, they're working on it, but I'll be honest with you, Beam is kind of... Beam, not a lot of people know about it. So, I would have to advertise the crap out of it and say, hey, I'm streaming on Beam tonight. I'm streaming on Beam tonight. And then, or tweet it. I think, honestly, with Beam, they ought to set it up to where when you Beam, it tweets, it Facebook posts. That would help it. That's just a suggestion that they could do. Whether they do it or not, I don't know. But yeah, let's see if it'll let me take a look and show you what's on the PlayStation 4. Let me see if it does. I guess I'll do that another time. It's not quite gonna work. I'd have to stop it and do it and all that stuff, but we'll get to that. Some announcements I guess I have is that Psycho Yellow or Razorblade Dreams, he's been playing the PlayStation 4 a lot. He's been loving Destiny. Even though he got Uncharted 4, he's been playing that a lot. That's mostly what all he plays, which is fine. That's cool. So a lot of time, I was hoping we'd be able to game a story mission out together, but he's in his own world doing that, and I understand. That's cool. I'm just glad he's got a system like that, so that way we can game sometime. But my thing is that I was wanting to say is, make sure when you go to gaming places, like a console place or something like that, like Walmart, make sure to check the apps, because a lot of the times there's going to be games on there that's going to be little to nothing. Make sure that the market thing says, the market says, thing says by Walmart. So that way, you know, they won't test it. But if it's by a third-party retailer, they're not going to honor it. Because apparently they had that issue before, because the lady was asking about that. But, alright, so this is what I'll do. Hold on just a minute. Let's do this. Alright, guys. This is the theme that I got for beating that game. This was Kingdom Hearts 2.0 Zero Fragment. They give you themes. Let me show you this right quick. For the 0.0 update. It's not that hard to do. Alright. So when I took all the games off of this and stuff, it brought it to, I don't know if y'all can see that, 319 gigs out of 918 that was used. Let's see what's on here. This. Okay, so your themes will not save on the hard drive. See how this looks. There, does that look better? Yeah, it looks a lot better. So the one thing, let's see what this has got. Let's look at the applications. Free space, I got 600.8 gigs. This is all the stuff that's downloaded on it. That's all the games. And that's pretty cool. Named it Daisy after my cat that I had to put to sleep on March 1st. That sucked. See if I can take things. We're going to see. No, I won't let you do that. I think those are saved files or something. Probably the licensing key if I had to guess. Save data. Okay, so the only thing you're able to do is delete it. Alright, so everything that I got on there, that I got on here is what you can do. You can only do games. Obviously, the saved games are going to stay on the PlayStation 4. That's fine. That's fine. But, does it run a little bit faster? Yeah, kind of. It kind of keeps it fresh and new, so you don't have to worry about that. Like, it kind of keeps that newness on there. We are going to see what... From Death Till Dawn looks like. Or Until Dawn, we're gonna see what that looks like. That's pretty cool. That's a free theme. I'm pretty sure Michael would like that. Alright, so that's what I'm doing. That's that on that. That's Robot Chicken theme. Let's see what we can do there. And that honestly wasn't a pain to do. It was really simple to do. Better than cracking open your case and doing that. And that's good that they did that, because now you can utilize both hard drives. So that was smart on Sony's part. I'm glad I joined in at the time I did. You just put it in there, go to user storage, it'll format it. Takes no time to do that. The only thing you can move on there is games. Can't move anything else on there. Save data, applications, all that stuff is still going to be on this on the PlayStation 4, but games can be moved over. So that's cool. That is cool. So yeah. So that's good. I just wanted to check on that. It's just aggravating when you do a stream and you're limited to certain things. You're limited on what you can do and what you can't do. And that's what really stunk. Now right now, turn on my phone. Pretty sure. Is supposed to get ready for church and she's hurting, so we're not going. That sucks because I'd gotten up early. that sucks. I got up early for that. I'm not even going. I could have slept in. Oh well. It's going 20 minutes in. So yeah, I just honestly for that game and stuff, just know, I mean, for streaming it's not as easy. I mean, I don't have the mocap card or whatever, but it is what it is. Maybe someday I'll get a lot of people watching it and stuff, but right now it's just a few people and it's fine, better than nobody. But and it's not getting many views. No, I mean, I'm not getting hit up where people are watching it constantly and everything else. It's like, it's whatever's there. My first stream had more people than anything, and I would like to change that. But that is my checkup number 6 on what's going on, just to let y'all know. I do have the Xbox One back. It's up there. So, yeah. My Beam name is beam.pro/psycho_break, which is spelled like my gamer tag. And it's like my game, it's actually spelled like my channel. Just put an underscore between the break, the cycle and the break, and you'll be able to pull it up. But yeah, that's it. Sorry for the incoherent rambling, but I wanted to get something up and check with you guys, let y'all know what's going on. So yeah. In the corner there, you see a little boy there. That was my brother. He, you know, that's Dustin right there. That's Dustin Trent, Dustin Warden Trent. He was my brother. He is my brother. But he passed away of cancer back in 1994. So every time I do a video, I always do a shout out with him by having him on that, having him right there. He passed away. He was 12. This was when we was early in school and stuff. And anyways, he would have been 30, 35 years old right now. Yeah. Whew. How times have changed. But anyways, guys, rate, comment, subscribe, and as always, break every chain. God bless y'all. And have a safe and wonderful Sunday morning. Regardless if you're religious, not religious, just be careful. Have a good one. God bless you.